Hello everyone, my name is Prasanna Kumar K. By qualification, I'm a chartered accountant, but by passion, I'm a teacher. So today, I'm doing a second chapter in 12th standard accountancy, that is accounting for partnership basic concepts. So this is the chapter name. So in first PUC business studies, I'm sure you would have studied this concept. Different forms of business organizations, correct? So these are the different forms of doing a business, right? So first one is a sole proprietorship. Sole proprietorship means sole trading concern or sole proprietorship. So sole trading concern means single person will run the business, only one individual. So he will invest capital, he will take part in the business, he will make all the decisions, he will run the business, and he will enjoy the entire profit. By any chance, if he suffers loss, he will incur entire loss. Okay, so this is the meaning of sole proprietorship. And the examples are, we got many examples like medical stores, stationery shops, etc. All these petty business, generally that is run by only single person. Okay, so next comes partnership business. So partnership means two or more persons, they will combine their financial resources. Financial resources means money or kind. So they will combine their money. So with that money, they will do the business. So this business is called as partnership business. Got it? So in case of sole proprietorship, only single person will run the business. But in case of partnership, more than two persons will run the business. So that is the meaning of partnership. And I'm sure you would have studied cooperative societies and then joint stock companies. But for the today's lecture, we will restrict our discussion to sole proprietorship as well as partnership. Okay, so this is the meaning of sole proprietorship and then partnership. See, this is the classic example for sole proprietorship. Everything is run by only a single person. See, all the works, each and everything, will be taken care by only single person, single individual. So that is called a sole proprietorship. So now we'll study the meaning of partnership. So partnership is an association of two or more persons. Minimum there should be a two persons, correct? To do the partnership business, minimum we need two persons, right? So two or more persons who have agreed to carry on the business, combining their financial resources. Financial resources means money. So they will combine their money and they will run the business and they will share the profit of such business. Let's take an example. Let's say A and B. So A and B combined their money. So basically this is called as capital. So with this money, they started one business, and whatever the profits that they generate from this business will be shared among A and then B. So this is the meaning of partnership. Okay. See. So this is a classic example for partnership. So they're combining all their resources. Assume that all these are resources. See, all these are combining the resources and it becomes one business now, one unit. So whatever the profit they will generate, that profit will be distributed among all the partners. Then you have to remember this definition. So this is the definition given by the Section 4 of Indian Partnership Act of 1932. Guys, remember this. If the question is write the meaning of partnership, then you can write in your own words. Okay. If the question is define partnership, then you have to write this definition. You are not supposed to alter even a single word in this. Okay. If the question is defined, you have to reproduce this answer as it is. Okay. So now we'll go to the next concept. So the next concept is partnership deed. So in simple words, partnership deed is nothing but it's an agreement. So it's an agreement which contains all the rules and regulations of the partnership, which is signed by all the partners and duly stamped according to the Stamp Act. So this is partnership deed, nothing but just agreement. I'm sure you would have seen a rental agreement, etc., etc. in your real life, correct? So like that, it is an agreement. It is an agreement between the partners. Or let's say A and B started one partnership business. So now A and B will make an agreement. So this agreement is called as partnership deed. So in this agreement, they will write all the rules and regulations of the partnership business. And both A and B will sign on that. Okay. And they will do this agreement usually in a stamp paper. Okay. So this is the meaning of partnership deed. So partnership deed is a written agreement containing the rules and regulations of partnership, which is signed by all the partners and duly stamped according to the Stamp Act. And these are the contents of partnership deed. So tell me, what will you write in partnership deed? Obviously, first thing is names and address of the partners, and then partnership firm, in the names and address of the partnership firm, then names and address of all the partners, then the name of the nature of the business, then capital contributed by each partner, profit and loss sharing ratio among the partner, duration if exists, if any, correct? Then salary or the drawings that can be drawn by the partner, etc., etc., etc. So all these are the contents of the partnership deed. Okay, let's take an example. So in my example, these two are the partners, Tom and then Jerry. Okay. So Tom and Jerry started one business. See, they're doing handshake now. They started one partnership business. So only two partners are there. So the first partner is Tom and the second partner is Jerry. So they both commenced the business, partnership business. Okay. Now this is the partnership business. See, they combined their financial resources, Tom and then Jerry, they combined their financial resources and there is the partnership business. Now it happened like this. This Tom is one partner. So Tom is withdrawing some money that is called as drawings. I'm sure you would have studied the meaning of drawings in your first PUC. So drawings means amount which is withdrawn by the partners or the proprietor from the business. So here Tom is a partner. So Tom withdrawn some money from the business. So that is the meaning of drawings. I hope you're getting the concept. So drawings means money which is withdrawn by the partners. That is the meaning of drawings. Okay, since the partner has drawn some money, so the partner needs to compensate. So to compensate that, the partner will pay interest on drawings to the business. Okay, so interest on drawings is payable by the partner to the business. Are you getting this? So drawings means amount withdrawn by the partner from the business. Now to compensate that, partner should pay interest on drawings to the business. Okay, that is the meaning of interest on drawings. So in nutshell, I will explain this. In nutshell, see, this is a business and here is the partner. So partner will withdraw money from the business, that is called as drawings. So to compensate that, partner should pay interest on drawings to the business. Okay, so now our job is to calculate interest on drawings. So to calculate interest on drawings, we got three methods. First one is a direct method or specific period method or product method, second one. Then third one is average period method. Okay, so there are three methods. Now we will solve a couple of questions under direct method. See, here is the question. Ram withdrew the following amounts. Calculate interest on drawings at 10% under specific method for the year ending 31st March 2016. So here is a question. See, observe carefully. The accounting year is ending on 31st March 2016. Therefore, accounting year will begin on 1/4/2015, correct? So generally, accounting year will begin on 1st April and ends on 31st March, correct? So accounting year will consist of 12 months generally. If nothing is specified, accounting year will consist of 12 months. So now Ram is a partner. So Ram has withdrawn 6,000 rupees on 1st May 2015. On 30th 8 2015, he has withdrawn, I'll make it 31st. So he has withdrawn 4,000 rupees. On 1st November, he has withdrawn 2,500 rupees. On 31st January, he has withdrawn 3,000 rupees. So these are the drawings which are made by the partner Ram. So now our job is to calculate interest on drawings under specific period method. Okay. So I'll put the heading. So So the heading is calculation of interest on drawings under specific period method or direct method. And I will make 5 columns. So first column is date, second column is amount, third column is outstanding months, and fourth column is calculation, and fifth column is interest. Okay. So now in the first column date, I will just copy paste this date as it is, which is given in the question. So see, this information is given in the question. I'll just do the copy paste. 1/5/2015, 31/8/2015, 1/11/2015, 31/1/2016. I'll just do the copy paste of this. And then even amounts is given in the question. So even amount, I'll just do the copy paste. 6,000, 4,000, 2,500 and 3,000 rupees. Okay, now we should calculate outstanding months. See, this here is the accounting period. So accounting period will begin from April, correct? And ends on 31st March. So begins on 1st April, but ends on 31st March. Okay, so accounting period will consist of 12 months. Accounting period will consist of 12 months. So now see the date here. So Ram has withdrawn 6,000 rupees on 1/5/2015. So fifth month is nothing but May, correct? So May 1st on this date, he has withdrawn 6,000 rupees. So now we should count the outstanding months. So count from here, May 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then 11. Okay. So the outstanding months are 11 months, correct? Now look at the second date. Second date is 31st August. So 31st August on this date, he has withdrawn 4,000 rupees. So we should count the outstanding period now. So count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here outstanding period is 7, correct? And the next date is 1/11/2015. So on this date, 1st November. So on this date, he has withdrawn 2,500 rupees. So count the outstanding months now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here I will write 5. Then 31 January. So 31st January here. So 31st January, he has withdrawn 3,000 rupees. Count the outstanding period, February and then March. Only 2 months. Okay. So these are the outstanding period. 11, 7, 5 and then 2. Got it? Now I will do the calculation. So as on this date, he has withdrawn 6,000 rupees, correct? And interest on drawings is charged at the rate of 10%. Look at the question. They said 10%, right? So now this will be the calculation. 6,000 into 10% into 11 by 12. You should calculate interest only for 11 months because Ram has withdrawn 6,000 rupees as on this date on 1st May 2015. So if you count the outstanding period, you will get only 11 months. So you should calculate interest only for 11 months. Got it? So you will get 550 rupees. Do this math. 6,000 into 10% into 11 by 12, you will get 550 rupees. Now, the next date is 31st August. On 31st August, he has withdrawn 4,000 rupees. So 31st August. Now count the number of outstanding months. You will get 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 months you will get. And the calculation will be like this. 4,000 into 7 by 12 into 10%. So you should calculate interest on drawings on this 4,000 only for 7 months. If you do that, you will get 233.33 rupees. So next date is 1st November. So count the number of outstanding months. November, December, January, February, and then March. You will get only 5 months, correct? So number of outstanding months are 5. So the calculation will be 2,500 into 10% into 5 by 12. You will get 104.17. Then 31st January. So number of outstanding months are only 2, February and then March. So calculate only for 2 months. 3,000 into 10% into 2 by 12. You will get 50 rupees, okay? So now if you add this, you will get total interest on drawings. That is 937.5 rupees. Just go through once. So we did one question on specific period method or direct method. We'll solve another question. So Rahim, a partner in a firm, withdrew the following amounts. Interest on drawings is to be charged at 12% per annum under specific period method for the year ending 31st March 2016. See, accounting year ends on 31st March 2016. So accounting year will begin on 1/4, correct? So 1/4 to 31st March. 1/4 to 31st March will consist of 12 months, correct? April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, Jan, Feb, and then March, correct? So accounting period consists of 12 months. On 31 May, he has withdrawn 3000 rupees. 31 May, this is May month. At the end of May, he has withdrawn 3000 rupees. So if you count the outstanding months, you will get only 10. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So number of outstanding months are 10. Then next, on 1/8/2015, he has withdrawn 4500 rupees on 1st August. So on 1st August, he has withdrawn 4500 rupees. So count the outstanding months. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Correct? So you will get 8 months. Then on 31/12, he has withdrawn 3,800 rupees. December 31st. So the outstanding months are only 3. Jan, Feb, and then March. So number of outstanding months are 3. Then 1/1/2016, 1st January. So 1st January, he has withdrawn again 5,000 rupees. Count the number of outstanding months. He will get Jan, Feb, and then March. Again, he will get 3 months. Just go through once. So now we need to calculate interest on drawings under specific period method. So the heading will be calculation of interest on drawings under specific period method or direct method. I'll make these columns: date, amount, outstanding months, calculation, and then interest. So dates, copy paste. Dates are given in the question: 31/5/2015, 1/8/2015, 31/12/2015, 1/1/2016. So dates, copy paste. It is given in the question. Given amounts, copy paste. Again, amounts are given in the question. I'll write as it is: 3000, 4500, 3800, and then 5000 rupees. Now outstanding months, we need to calculate the outstanding months. See, the date is 31/5/2015. So ignore May, count from June. We will get 10 months, correct? So here I will write 10 months. So here we get 8 months, and here we get 3, and here we get 3. And here the calculation will be 3000 rupees into, see, on this date, the amount of drawings is 3000. So 3000 into rate is 12%, right? So 3000 into 12/100 into, so we should calculate interest only for 10 months. So into 10/12. So do this math: 3000 into 12/100 into 10/12. So do it in your calculator: 3000 into 12/100 into 10/12. You will get 300 rupees. Okay, then second amount is 4500. So 4500 into interest is 12%. So 12/100 into number of outstanding months are only 8. So into 8/12. So again, do this math: 4500 into 12%. Into 8/12. If you do that, you will get 360 rupees. So again, 3800. Here the amount is 3800. So 3800 into rate is 12% into outstanding months are only 3. So we should calculate only for 3 months. So do this math: 3800 into 12%. Into 3/12. If you do that, you will get 114 rupees. Now here the amount is 5000. So 5,000 into 12%, and outstanding months are only 3. So into 3 by 12. So again, do this math. So 5,000 into 12 by 100 into 3 by 12. Do that, you will get 150 rupees. So now add this 300 plus 360 plus 114 plus 150. So add this, you will get 924. So this is total interest on drawings under specific period method. I hope you are getting this. I'll go to the next question. So Joseph withdrew the following amounts. Calculate interest on drawings at 8% per annum under specific method for the year ending 31/12/2015. So again, we need to calculate interest on drawings under specific period method. Guys, this is the question, right? The first thing is you need to put this heading. The heading is calculation of interest on drawings under specific period method or direct method. Then you should make 5 columns: date, amount, outstanding months, calculation, and then interest. We will do this together. First you put the heading, calculation of interest on drawings under specific period method. Then you make these 5 columns: date, amount, outstanding months, calculation, and then interest. So first column is date, copy paste. See whatever given in the question, 31/5/2015, 1/7/15, 31/10, then 1/11, you just copy paste that. So as it is. Then second column is amount, again copy paste. Look at the question, 2500, 3000, 4000, 3500. Okay, now we need to calculate the outstanding months. So how to calculate outstanding months? See here, the accounting year is ending on 31/12/2015. Be careful, the accounting year is ending on 31st December. Therefore, accounting year will begin on 1st January. So 1st January 2015 to 31st December 2015. So accounting year will consist of 12 months. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Got it? Then, on 31/5/2015, Joseph has withdrawn 2500 rupees. Now look at the date, 31/5. So 2 months are gone, sorry. 31/5. Here is 31/5. Correct? Already 5 months are gone. Jan, Feb, March, April, and then May. Ignore those 5 months. Count the remaining months. June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Count the number of months. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You will get 7 months. And here the next date is 1/7/2015. 1st July. 1st July. We should include even July month also. So count from here. So July to December. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So number of outstanding months are 6. The next date is 31/10, 31st October. Now count the number of outstanding months, November and then December, only 2 months. The next one is 1/11. So beginning of the November month. So the number of outstanding months will be only 2, November and then December. Now we'll do the calculation. On 31/5/2015, he has withdrawn 2,500 rupees. So 2,500 into rate is 8%. Look at the question. See the first sentence, 8%, right? So 8 by 100 into 7 by 12 because outstanding months are only 7. So 2500 into 8% into 7 by 12. So do this math, 2500 into 8% into 7 by 12. If you do that, you will get 116.66. I will make it 67. Okay. Now look at the second date. So second date is 1 July 2015, amount is 3000 rupees, number of outstanding months are 6. So 3000 into 8%, that is 8 by 100 into 6 by 12. So 3000 into 8% into 6 by 12. If you do that math, you will get 120 rupees. Then next amount is 4000. So 4000 into 8%, that is 8 by 100 into 2 by 12, because outstanding months are only 2. 4000 into 8% into 2 by 12. So you will get 53.33. Then next amount is 3500. So 3500 into 8% into 2 by 12. So do this math. 3500 into 8% into 2 divided by 12. If you do that, you will get 46.66. Okay, now add this. If you add, you will get total interest on drawings. So add everything. 116.67 plus 120 plus 53.33 plus 46.66. If you add everything, you will get 336.66 rupees. So we calculated interest on drawings under specific period method. So practice these questions again. In the next class, we will learn calculation of interest on drawings under product method. That's the next method.